Hello everyone and welcome to my channel Swanasha Fine Art. I am Ashana and today I'm going to show you how I created this mixed media drawing of Minnie Mouse in her red polka dotted dress. This character in this outfit you can find in every Disney park of the world. Before I start with showing you the drawing process, all the materials that I used to create this drawing are listed and linked in the video description. If you are interested to see more drawing videos or you want to see more of my tutorials, hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to get a notification when a new video is uploaded on this channel. Now let's move on to the drawing. Before I painted the background, I used masking fluid to cover specific areas in my drawing, like Minnie Mouse. The masking fluid protects those areas against the watercolor paint. Masking fluid is also great to create highlights in your drawings, such as the white in a portrait's eyes. For the background, I use a combination of the Faber-Castell Albrecht Dürer watercolor pencils and the Aqua Marcos from DecoTime. I love both of these materials because they work very well together on this paper and the colors are very bright and colorful. I don't use the Aqua Marcos for larger areas in my backgrounds because they do not fill up that area very much and backgrounds are large areas. Also, when you use the Aqua Marcos, they have less pigment than watercolor pencils and paint. I did use the Aqua Marcos for smaller areas in my background, like the ribbons, but also for faces, clothing and smaller elements in my drawing. I use a paintbrush to apply the pigments of the marker in my drawing. In the pop-up card right now in this video, you can see different techniques that you can do with these markers. This is also a short review of the Aqua Marcos from DecoTime. Everything that I see is coming up roses. After I finished the background and the ribbon that is in the background, I worked on the cartoon version of Minnie Mouse by coloring her dress and bow. Before I add the paint on these areas, I used the wet on wet technique to make the elements in my drawing soft looking. There's also the wet on dry technique, but I recommend to use this technique for details such as eyes, noses and lips. To use the wet on wet technique on your drawing, apply water on the paper in the area you're going to work on, and after that you directly paint over this area with the watercolor paint. Be careful not to apply too much water on the paper, otherwise you get these puddles on the paper and this gives a not good looking result in the end. If you do have too much water on your paper or these puddles, then you can carefully remove this by dipping a tissue on the puddle, or you can use a pipette to absorb the water from your drawing. So infectious, a new direction, you can feel the fever.
I'm a girl.
Another tip for working with watercolors is that you apply the lighter colors first on the paper, and after they completely dry, you apply the dark colors on top of them or to an area next to the lighter colors. This is one of the most important tips for working with watercolors because it is very hard to work from dark to light with this medium. When I started with watercolors a few months ago, I applied some dark colors on a specific area first, and then used lighter colors in the area next to the darker area. The issue was that at the edges of the darker colors, they bleeded into the lighter areas of my drawing. So I had a lot of trouble to fix the lighter area because the darker colors bleeded into that area. After that mistake, I kept in my mind that with my next drawings with watercolors, I need to apply the lighter colors first and then work on top with the darker colors or at the area next to them. So as you can see in my drawing, I use the reds and the yellows first because these are the more lighter colors, and then I use the color black for the ears and the eyes of Minnie Mouse because this is a very dark color. My last tip for working with watercolors, and this tip is more for details in your drawing, is that you can use other mediums to give your artwork not only more contrast, but also sharper details and a more finished look. For the details in my drawings with watercolors, I like to use a combination of colored pencils, markers, and gouache. The brands of colored pencils I like to use the most are the Faber-Castell Polychromos, Decotime colored pencils, and the Caran d'Ache Pablo colored pencils. These pencils are great for working on top of watercolors because they are very creamy and the colors are very bright. But any other brand of colored pencils works also well with watercolors, so it depends which pencils you are most comfortable with. The same works with markers. I like to use the Aqua markers and the Twin markers from Decotime. They are available at the Action, and I like these because they are very cheap and you have a lot of color combinations with these markers. For the highlights in my drawing, I like to use white gouache. I do have other gouache at my home right now, but I haven't had a chance to work with this, so I like to use the white gouache for the white in the eyes of the portrait, but also for very bright highlights in my drawing. Thank you for watching. If you are interested to watch more of my YouTube videos, don't forget to subscribe on my YouTube channel, or if you want to check out more of my artwork, then check out the social media links in the video description. See you next time. Bye bye.